Greetings, beautiful people, and welcome back to another first-time reaction to an anime opening. And man, literally since I started reacting to anime openings, this is just another one on that list that you guys have been screaming at me to react to. I don't know why, but I've heard the soundtrack around the Seven Deadly Sins anime is absolutely amazing. You guys have hyped it up, compared it to some of the best that we've reacted to so far. So, I think it is safe to say I'm a little bit hyped and I'm a little bit excited to check this one out. It comes so highly recommended. I've got high expectations, I'm not gonna lie. I'm looking forward to hearing this one. So I'm gonna keep this intro nice and short and jump straight into this. But before I do, I just wanna let all of you know that this week we are going to be picking which anime we start watching on Twitch. If you aren't following me on Twitch, you're gonna miss out. Next week and the week after, we're going to start our very first anime watch-along series live on Twitch. Link to my Twitch channel is in the description, and all of you get to pick which anime we start with. So, if you want to be a part of that, make sure you follow me on Twitch. Link in the description. Enough of my talking! Let's jump into my first time ever reaction to the Seven Deadly Sins openings.
But first, let me tell you about today's sponsor. Today's video is sponsored by Raid Shadow Legends. Raid Shadow Legends is a completely free-to-play hero collection RPG played by over 80 million players across the world. Whenever I talk about Raid Shadow Legends, one question always gets asked me, Luke, who are your top three favorite heroes? Well, that's easy. As a massive fan of horror, all of my favorite heroes come from the Undead Hordes faction. Harvest Jack, just because he's awesome and literally looks absolutely incredible. The artwork on that character is amazing. And Corpse Collector and Hexia as well, just because they look so damn terrifying in all the best ways. And recently, Raid Shadow Legends has done something truly special by introducing a legendary hero, none other than the one and only MMA pro wrestler, Ronda Rousey. To get your Ronda Rousey champion, log in and play Raid for 7 days between now and February 20th. Also use the special code RAIDRONDA if you are a new or existing player to get yourself 3-day 100 XP boost, 500k silver, and 5 energy refills. And currently, Raid Shadow Legends is running its Christmas event. For all new players, get ready to celebrate the 12 days of Raid. Download Raid, copy your player ID, and then go to 12daysofraid.plarium.com. Link in the description. The event runs from December 19th to January 10th. Play the new minigame for a chance to win real-life and in-game prizes, including holiday-themed Raid champions and even Amazon gift cards worth up to $1,000. And for existing players, you can head over to the same link as well to get yourself a special Christmas gift. And if you haven't started playing Raid Shadow Legends yet, click my link in the description or scan the QR code on the screen, and you'll get unique bonuses worth up to $30 free. We are talking a free epic champion, Ana. 200k silver, 1 energy refill, 1 XP boost, and 1 ancient shard. Don't wait, all this treasure is waiting for you right now over the next 30 days. Don't miss out. Thank you, Raid Shadow Legends, for the sponsor. Now, back to the video.
Very good vocals, by the way. I just want to point out already, really, really good vocals. Whenever I hear like a strong female voice like this, a Japanese singer, I'm always curious to know their name, and I always want to know if they've done a first take. Very, very good. We're gonna play my favorite game, by the way, which is try to understand what the anime is about without knowing anything about the anime. Let's see if I get it even close. Interesting. Okay. At first, I thought it was about two people being marooned on an island together, but then it introduced loads of new characters, and then it introduced like fantasy elements with people flying around and stuff, and then it introduced a very attractive, you know, gazonged giant woman. And I was like, okay, so there's giant people in this universe now? And then the pig suddenly became giant as well? So, I don't know. I guess we keep going. The song was very, very good. Very, very good vocalist. Loved her voice. I very well animated. I think Seven Deadly Sins is supposed to be a bit of an older anime. It looks interesting. All right. And the song was fantastic as well. Song was very, very good. I've heard the songs are very good. So I'm looking forward to seeing the opening. The pain and the pleasure all come together. There's no reason why. I've heard this before. I've 100% heard this before. This might be in the top 100 animes of all time. Anime openings of all time. They do 5-second clips of each anime opening. I swear this one was in there. I've definitely heard this one clip. I've heard it. The pain and the pleasure all come together. There's no reason why. Don't play that. I got my demons, they don't know. I'm fierce enough to let them know. It's like a fire, a stranglehold. I wish I was invincible. Hello, desire, you're my old friend. But I don't need you here again. Holy shit, this is taking like a really dark turn really quickly. I did not expect this. Just saw the first opening alone. I thought this was going to be like a lighthearted sort of Dragon Ball Z style anime. Doesn't feel like that at all. Just take a walk, go back inside. I'll see you on the other side. The main character reminds me a little bit of Armin, like same sort of face and structure as Armin. That one felt a lot darker at the beginning. I'm very curious now. Is this going to be like another Hunter x Hunter where I guess that it is lighthearted and easy and then people are like, no, it's not, trust me. I must admit, I am a fan of the giant lady. I like her. That's my kind of woman. That's just what I'm just saying. I like the giant lady. Damn, I am, shit. This has got to stop happening. Because the amount of animes, I'm not even joking, by the way, when I tell you this. I have a list of anime openings that I really think I would like. That list is getting too long. And already two openings in, I feel like I'm going to be adding the Seven Deadly Sins to that list. Outfits the women wear. I'm just saying they're very interesting. Like even that one shot. Also the soundtracks. I can see why people say the Seven Deadly Sins is amazing openings. All three of them so far fucking awesome. Songs are awesome, but these songs are awesome. There's a song that all three of them have been like 8 to 10 out of 10. It's easy. This looks awesome. This looks so damn good. Holy shit. It looks awesome. The action looks crazy. The characters look really cool. So is it basically about, like, it looks like the X-Men. It looks like, that's what it feels like. It feels like we have, like, the good X-Men and the bad X-Men. We've got all these different powers and abilities and people fighting each other. And it also looks like some sort of demonic creatures as well in this. It looks really good. It looks really, really fucking good. And I always find that if the opening song is fantastic, it makes you sort of feel for, like, the anime opening in general and the anime as well. And the opening songs have all been awesome. 3 out of 9 we've done so far. We're on the 4th one now. All 3 of them, I have loved. Let's see if they continue this trend. Can we get a full... Can we just get, like, a full house here? Can we? I like that. Is this a pop band? This sounds like a pop band. This sounds like a pop band. I can't tell if it's J-pop or K-pop. But definitely definitely a pop band maybe. Looks so cool, man. It looks so cool. What was up with that cuddle, man? Where was your head resting? Look at this. This looks like so much fun. This looks so much fun. The fight scenes look fucking amazing. That was another very, very good song as well. Another very, very good song. Actually, I can see. The song was... it doesn't say who sung it. Oh, Skypiece. Skypiece was the name of the artist. Right. We have literally had consistently good songs now. Let's see if Opening 5 continues this trend. I can see why so many people recommended The 7 Deadly Sins. The soundtrack for this anime is insane. Wait a second. 2, 4, 6, 7. Ah, are these the 7 deadly sins? Are the 7 deadly sins supposed to be animals? Is that what this is? They all have the tattoos. Interesting. All right. I, at the end of this video, I'll see what I think. I'll say what I think this anime is about. Everyone who's watched this anime, is this as good as it looks? Because it looks fucking awesome. It really does. is incredible. It has been a long time since I reacted to an anime opening series, like multiple videos in one, and I've just been blown away by the songs. This is so impressive. Holy shit! The songs have all been so good. I would listen to all of these. Every single one. There's not one weak link. All of them are incredible. Fucking hell, man. You can already tell with this fast guitar that this is just going to be another one as well. They've all got like battle armor on now as well. This looks so interesting, man. This is piquing my interest, guys. This looks like a lot of fun. What was that? The main protagonist just like turned into like a demonic flipping sky bat devil creature and like flew off into the sky. Okay. A rough draft of what I think this is about. It seems like just a simple battle of good versus evil, and there are abilities on both sides that they can harness the power of these seven deadly sins, for example, and each one of these people has this tattoo that gives them that power, that enhanced power, and they're trying to protect something. That's literally it. It's very vague. I can't really go much more in depth because I honestly don't know. The fights look fantastic. The art style looks fantastic. The character, characterization, I don't know the word, but they all look fantastic as well. The art style, everything, it looks like my kind of anime. I'm interested to know if this is a dark or a light-hearted anime. We also keep seeing like the Ten Commandments being brought up as well. And now with this, it seems like there's some sort of like angel, maybe demonic presence there as well. I mean, with a show like The Seven Deadly Sins, you would presume something along those lines. Even though this song is much more on the pop side, this is still a fantastic song, and the visuals that I'm seeing right now look mind-blowingly awesome. This is something I haven't really seen much of before in anime openings or anime scenes that I've seen so far in general, which is like a couple an actual, like, main protagonist couple, where they look like they're in love and they're helping each other and cuddles and that sort of stuff. I haven't really seen that yet. A lot of the time you see, like, the chase for, like, a relationship, and it, like, will they, won't they, maybe they will, maybe they won't, they kind of like each other. You see that a lot, but you don't actually just see a couple, like, a strong in-love couple. This is a first for me, and I must admit, I like it. I really like it, because it's just, I haven't seen this before, which is actually really weird saying that out loud, but it's not something you see much, which is strange. Anyway, this is technically the last opening, but there is a ninth one we're going to react to as well, but it's an OVA, so, we're going to do both. Of course we're going to do both. I'm going to say it right now. I've loved every single one of these. Great voice, and heavy on the piano as well, I like that. The art style and the fights remind me a little bit of what I saw in the Black Clover openings. I'm curious, are all of these sort of animes in that same sort of subgenre, whatever it is? I still don't know all the genres. I am trying to learn. I don't know how to pronounce them, I don't know the different ones. I know there's like PG and rated R, but they're called something else. But is this in the same genre as like Black Clover? Or is this dark? Feel like what I'm seeing is like it's supposed to sort of circle around friendship and relationships and bonds that these people are all sharing and having together. That's what I'm getting from this as well. Also, this song, fucking fantastic, absolutely amazing, just like every single song I've listened to on this opening for the Seven Deadly Sins anime. All of them have been incredible. This anime looks awesome, man. It looks so awesome. It looks awesome. Right. The Seven Deadly Sins OVA. I don't actually know what that means. I don't actually know what OVA means. No clue. So I'm a bit confused about this one, but it was in the openings list. So let's do it. The last one. Signs of a Holy War. I love the house on like the giant pig. Oh, I thought the pig got giant. Is there more than one pig? She's got a little pig on her shoulder. There's more than one pig? I didn't realize that. Seen a lot of like this anime looks like so much fun, man. It just looks like a hell lot of fun. It really does. It's just nice. It just looks fun. It looks like not too dark, not too light, somewhere nice and happy medium. It looks like the fight scenes are going to be incredible. It looks very enjoyable. The characters look very well done as well. Like, already watching this, I feel like I can remember and see each character as well. They're very distinctive. I don't know what this anime is in terms of ratings, because I always find it interesting, because I react to the openings, I go into them blind, I do no background research, so I don't actually know if The Seven Deadly Sins is considered a good anime. I don't know. You guys are going to tell me in the comments section when I read the comments. All I know is people have been telling me that the soundtrack around The Seven Deadly Sins, the openings, is amazing. I don't know if the endings are as good, just let me know. But I've heard the openings to this are amazing. I can tell you all right now, everyone who has said that, you are not wrong. These openings are easily some of the best I have heard, just in terms of consistency. We just listened to 9 different clips from songs right now. Every single one of them was great. Every single song was a very, very well done song. Sounded very, very good. Had a very strong vocalist. The instrumental was fantastic. Every single song was good. I would listen to every single one of these songs again. Every single one. It's rare you listen to an anime opening playlist, and every single one is great. It's rare it happens. Usually there's a few weak ones, usually a few softer ones, usually a few unusual ones. It's rare they're all good. But yeah, Seven Deadly Sins, I think might have done it. This was crazy. The anime I'm very curious about. So for me personally, what after watching all these openings, what I feel like the anime is about is literally what the clue is in the name. I feel like the anime is like, sort of follows like maybe a religious holy war background where, I don't know what between... but you have the Seven Deadly Sins, which are somehow part of that war, which is the characters we saw. I don't think they're the Seven Deadly Sins. However, they possess the ability of the Seven Deadly Sins. And they use this to try and warn off evil. I'm guessing that wants to maybe get that power or is trying to take over the world. And they're part of like this holy war trying to defend it. Like a rag team of X-Men in a way. And they're fighting what you would see as the evil X-Men. Am I close? Am I even close? I never am usually close. I'm usually miles away. We did a reaction to Angel Beats recently, and all of you just messaged me. I'm like, nope, you weren't even a little bit close. So I'm interested. What I know, this is about like a hedgehog that writes books and wants to become a publisher. I didn't see a hedgehog, but you never know with openings. Openings usually are very misleading, so you can never really tell what the hell the anime is about from the openings. For all I know, I watched the anime, none of these characters are in it. Like, you never know. But yeah, this looks awesome. The fight scenes look incredible. The characters look really cool. It just looks like a lot of fun. Is it wrapped up? Is there another season coming? Is it over? Is this the end of it? Let me know in the comment section down below. Let me know what all of you think about this anime. Let me know if you guys think I would enjoy it. And also, let me know, what's your favorite anime? What's your favorite anime openings? Or what's your favorite soundtrack from an anime? And what would all of you like me to react to next? What's an anime opening playlist I haven't done yet that all of you would like me to react to next? Put all your recommendations in the comments section down below. I try and read as many comments in every single video I upload as I can. So if you've got a recommendation, all you need to do, put it down below and I'll probably see it. And don't forget, at 300,000 subscribers, we're going to be doing a $1,000 giveaway. So make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss out on that. And also, don't forget, on Twitch, we're going to be starting our first ever anime watch-along series. So make sure you follow me on Twitch so you don't miss out on that. And you can vote and join me for what anime I should start on Twitch with all of you live. Links for everything is in the description. But other than that, have an absolutely wonderful Christmas, a happy holidays, a fantastic new year, wherever you are in the world. Thank you so much for supporting this channel. I'd be nothing without each and every single one of you. I honestly love you guys. You're absolutely incredible. I hope you have the best weekend ever. Thank you so much for watching this video. And as always, my friends, you see me in the next video.